Well, back in the late 1990s, when the Howard government decided to take on the waterfront unions, it sparked scenes rarely witnessed before in this country. And now history could be about to repeat itself over a fresh wage dispute. Well, earlier today, Danny Isdale caught up with a couple of old waterfront combatants and found that the wounds still run extremely deep.
A new fight on an old battleground is brewing.
We've waited patiently for the ability to negotiate a new agreement over the last 3 years, and in that time there's been a horrific safety and particularly death toll. And we want that addressed, and we're not patient about that part.
The agreement expired late last year. What's brought you to this point, this stalemate?
Frustration. We'd been going for 7 months. We're very concerned that the company may be using a process of not bargaining in good faith just to get an effectively not meet the questions that we want answers to.
The Maritime Union and Patrick Stevedores can't agree on a pay rise for the nation's wharfies, so legally protected strikes will roll out across the country from Saturday.
And they're taking advantage, really, to the great expense of, and cost to other Australians. It's the first time we've had some really serious and bad strike action by the MUA for nearly 12 years.
Peter Reith, of course, recalls 1998 very well. As John Howard's then Industrial Relations Minister, he was at the heart of that famous waterfront dispute. Then, under different ownership, the company locked out its unionised workforce and brought in strike breakers. Skip!
Skip! It was a very good result for Australia. It was great for our exporters, great for our importers. Australia's an island continent. We need to have efficient wharves.
Paddy Crumlin fought on the union's front line. He remembers it very differently.
Mr. Reith returns from the crypt. You know, it's like a B-grade horror movie saying, "I told you so." We got on with the job. The job is keeping Australia moving, and we're proud of the fact that we're right at the centre of that.
But that was then.
And this is now, and while very different, Patrick says this rolling industrial action will not only be commercially damaging and crippling for productivity, they also say it will hurt Australian businesses already suffering after the floods and other natural disasters.
It's dumb as dog shit. The reality is that we would never do that. Our members live in Queensland. So to get out there and accuse us of this sort of moral vandalism is like a cheap shot and only confirms to us that this company's bankrupt of ideas.
But ready as ever, it seems, for a fight.
Danny Isdale there.